Beneath the black canopy of the ocean, where sunlight drowns and sound is swallowed whole, predators glide without a ripple. They do not roar, they wait. Their breath is steam, their blood is uranium, and their heartbeat is a silent, steady hum. These are Russia's newest ocean hunters, the Yasen and Yasen-M class nuclear submarines, Project 885 and 885M. Tonight, we descend into their world. We will meet five shadows by name. Severodvinsk, K560. Kazan, K561. Novosibirsk, K573. Krasnoyarsk, K571. Arkhangelsk, K564. And learn how they were forged, how they stalk, how they strike, and how they vanish. In this story, there are no heroes. Only steel, silence, and the thin line between peace and catastrophe. The Yasen story is born in the wreckage of the Soviet collapse. Budgets imploded. Projects died. But one survivor endured. Project 885, a new kind of hunter, built not for coastal defense, but for long-reach strikes, carrier killing, and silent deterrence. Severodvinsk, K560, the prototype, would take decades from concept to sea. When she finally sailed in the 2010s, Western analysts took notice. The old giants were gone, no more lumbering behemoths, but something sleeker, quieter, and far more dangerous had emerged. Then came the evolution. Yasen-M, Project 885M, refined hull form, quieter machinery, modernized sensors, improved combat system integration, and a vertical launch suite for land attack and anti-ship missiles. If Typhoon was the sledgehammer of the Cold War, Yasen is the scalpel of the present. Severodvinsk, K560. History. The first of her kind, Severodvinsk is the proof of concept, long delayed, closely studied, and unforgettable. She entered service in the early 2010 and immediately became Russia's testbed for new tactics and weapons. Capabilities. She carries a bank of vertical launch cells, amidships for long-range cruise missiles. In her torpedo room, heavyweight torpedoes and anti-ship weapons. She is wired with a large bow sonar array and flank arrays that listen for the faintest signatures. Propellers half a world away, hull vibrations masked by storms, the hush of a distant carrier task force. How it works. Her pressurized water nuclear reactor drives turbines through shock-isolated machinery to minimize noise. Anechoic treatments and hydrodynamic shaping dampen self-noise. She is built to hear before she is heard, to classify before she is found. Strike profile. When she attacks, Severodvinsk typically does not need to be seen. From deep water, she can launch land attack cruise missiles that skim the sea or hug terrain, and anti-ship missiles designed to break carrier screens. After firing, she slides down the thermal ladder, changing depth to hide in temperature layers, and turns away to let distance and ocean physics erase her wake. Kazan, K561. History. Kazan is the first of the improved Yasen-M line. Commissioned in the early 2020s, she embodies the lessons learned from Severodvinsk. Fewer vibrations, tighter machinery tolerances, optimized acoustic tiles, integrated combat architecture. Capabilities. Kazan is designed to be exceptionally quiet. Her vertical launch suite can host a mix of long-range land attack and anti-ship missiles, including next-generation options, while her torpedo armament allows close-in ambushes and anti-submarine engagements. How it works. Think of Kazan as a blind hunter with perfect hearing. The ocean is her map, salinity temperature, and current all become tools. She parks in the right layer and lets targets reveal themselves by physics alone. Strike profile. Against land targets, she can execute a standoff strike. Launch from international waters. Let the missiles do the traveling. Against fleets, she can lurk ahead of a predicted route, then fire a mixed salvo. Sea skimmers and high altitude profiles to saturate defenses. She finishes by going deep and quiet, leaving confusion in her wake. Novosibirsk, Kai-573. History. Novosibirsk expands the shadow into the Pacific. Entering service in the early 2020s, she joined Russia's Pacific Fleet, shifting attention toward Japan, Guam, and the U.S. West Coast. Capabilities. Her mission set overlaps her sister's. Land attack, sea denial, carrier group harassment, and high-value target stalking. She carries the same vertical launch bank and torpedo suite, giving commanders flexible, layered options. How it works, the Pacific is a noisy ocean, rich with shipping lanes and powerful currents. Novosibirsk uses that chaos as cover. In heavy traffic, everything makes noise. The art is becoming the one sound no one can separate from the rest. Strike profile. From the Western Pacific, Novosibirsk can threaten naval bases and logistics nodes with long-range cruise missiles or shadow valuable fleets and wait. Her ideal strike is pre-planned, time-on-target coordinated, using multiple approach vectors to complicate defender's radar picture. Then a silent breakaway, slipping under a cold layer as aircraft and ASW ships chase echoes. Krasnoyarsk, K-571. History. Commissioned mid-decade, Krasnoyarsk represents the maturing production of Yasen-M for the Pacific Theater. Capabilities. Beyond caliber and anti-ship missiles, she is often associated with next-gen hypersonic options in Russian doctrine. The message is simple. There is no safe distance. How it works. A modern combat system fuses sonar, intelligence inputs, and oceanographic models. The crew's task is judgment, choosing the depth, the course, the speed that transforms a vast ocean into a cloak. Strike profile. Against a carrier group, Krasnoyarsk's doctrine favors multi-axis saturation, staggered attack paths and altitudes, forcing defenses to split attention and intercept windows. She does not linger. In the acoustic chaos that follows, she goes cold and disappears. Arkhangelsk, K-564. History. Arkhangelsk is among the newest of the lineage, joining Russia's northern fleet in the mid-2020s. Every berth in this class signals a long game, a fleet built to outlast crises and alter calculations in the Atlantic. Capabilities. The template holds vertical launch strike power plus heavyweight torpedoes, but each new hull refines quieting measures and ship control, making incremental progress toward the goal. Be heard last. How it works. In the North Atlantic, Arkhangelsk treats the ocean like a layered labyrinth. Temperature gradients bend sound. Seafloor features create shadows. She positions herself where enemy sonar struggles most. Strike profile. Arkhangelsk's likely role is deterrent presence, being out there unseen, able to reach European targets or shadow high-value ships. If ordered to fire, she executes a brief, violent conversation. Hatches open. Steel speaks. Hatches shut. And the ocean returns to silence. How they vanish. Stealth, sensors, doctrine. Yasen-M reduces self-noise with isolated machinery, refined propulsor design, and careful hydrodynamics. Anechoic materials help scatter active sonar energy. The hull form and internal layout are tuned to lower vibration. Sensors. A large bow sonar and flank arrays listen constantly. Towed arrays, when deployed, widen the ear. The combat system integrates contacts over time, one faint bearing today, another tomorrow. Threads that become a track, a pattern, a plan. Oceanography as a weapon. Thermal layers refract sound. By changing depth, a submarine can hide beneath a layer where enemy sonar weakens. Bottom contours can mask noise, channels can carry it, eddies and fronts can both reveal and conceal. Yasen crews study the water like pilots study the sky. Doctrine. The guiding idea is detect first, shoot first, vanish first. Yasen boats prefer standoff launches from contested but international waters, minimizing exposure. After a strike, they change depth, speed, and course, sometimes deploying decoys to mislead active searchers. The goal is not glory, it is uncertainty. Combat reality to date. As of now, these submarines are tools of deterrence more than battlefield hammers. Their power isn't measured in craters, but in caution. The extra escorts, the longer routes, the sleepless nights in operation centers that whisper, "Where is the submarine?" What the ocean hides, five names, Severodvinsk, Kazan, Novosibirsk, Krasnoyarsk, Arkhangelsk, five shadows of the Yasen/Yasen-M class. They are not famous because they strike. They are feared because they can, and because they choose not to be seen. The ocean keeps their secrets. The silence keeps their edge. And somewhere tonight, a steel hunter drifts beneath the waves, listening to a world that has no idea it is being watched. If you want more journeys into the hidden machinery of power, subscribe, like, comment, and share. Because the next story waits where the light cannot follow.